See our session snaps right now.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
Here I am at BBC Introducing in Hereford and Worcester Sunday session with Bo and the boys. Bo Walton and his band. Hello, guys.
Hey, how you doing?
Ooh, chorus of men. How did you find that?
Yeah, it was good fun to get the boys together and have a crack and then play it to an audience, which is always...
I thought it was absolutely amazing.
Thank you very much.
It was really, everyone was stood up for the whole four songs, which has not actually happened before, probably in the history, I don't think. You know, everyone's kind of sheepishly sitting down.
Well, we've had people fall over before.
What, girls fainting?
No, I'm afraid not. Drunk boys, but...
Oh, right. Oh, well, maybe one day. Well, I thought it was absolutely fabulous and the crowd was certainly enjoying it. How long have you been together? How long has this been going on?
I've been doing this for... a couple of years really, and I formed the band probably about 2 weeks ago, I think.
Pretty much from scratch.
I mean, I played with the boys before in various different other sort of bands, but to actually gig this material, it's the first time in about 2 weeks that we've played together live, and it's the first time that we've done anything together for about 2 weeks that involves all of us. So, does that make sense? I don't know.
Yeah, it does. So, let's have a quick round. Who's here? We've got Bo Walton, obviously.
I'm Bo.
I'm Kinsey, I'm the bass player.
Tom, guitar.
Greg, on drums.
Blakey, guitar.
So, as well, I spoke to Graham earlier from Tabitha. How long have you guys been with them?
About 3-4 months, I think. Okay. Yeah, we sent some music into him with a view to him publishing the tunes. Mm-hmm. And he picked up on the tunes and the voice as well. So we just sort of moved from a publishing deal to a record deal. And it's sort of blossomed from there. So yeah, we've got the first single's out at the moment. It's Too Much is out on CD single at the moment. Uh-huh. Got the second single, Wild at Heart, coming out on the 27th of January for download only, iTunes, Amazon, the lot. And then the album, Waiting on a Dream, will be with you on the 28th of February.
Wonderful.
So we're moving forward nicely.
And what about any more plans? Tours and stuff like that as well coming up?
Or? We're doing well, yeah. The boys are geared for it now, so we've had two rehearsals. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're good to go.
Third rehearsal, and then we'll probably get on.
Excellent, yeah. Just get out of there nice and early. You can practice while you're there, can't you?
That's the plan.
Excellent. So big tour van planned, you know, lots of ladies in the back, or maybe.
Should we answer that?
What goes on stage? And you guys have got such a long and accomplished history. Andrew was telling me you played with Mark Knopfler, is that right?
Mark Knopfler played on a couple of tunes, yeah. One of which will be on the album, one of which is on the single at the moment. So if people want to hear it, they have to download it or buy the CD single. That's Too Much. He played on Hey Mr. Night, which is the second track on the single.
Right, so how did that happen? How did you end up getting in touch with him?
We approached his manager and said, because Mark plays very much a country style, and the music that we do is predominantly country and rock and roll, it would be something that maybe he'd be interested in playing on. And his manager came back and said, absolutely, he chose two songs to play. And the rest is, as I say, history.
And is it easy to get together with, because with five of you, with, you know, family, work, commitments and stuff like that, has it been a struggle or...?
Greg's got as many bands as there are members in this one, I think.
Really, Greg, so. How many bands are you in?
Eight.
Eight?
He's got more
eight.
I was chasing at one point, but I think five's mine at the moment.
So yeah, we've all got lots of different things on the go. Different
musical infidelity, £8. I'm sorry.
I don't like it.
So what's the long-term plan then?
At this stage, we need to see how the second single goes and promote the album with that as well. And as we say, tour, local tours and sort of the UK, and hopefully branch further afield. We've had interest from both Germany and Sweden at the moment. We're getting interviews and stuff in the US as well. So hopefully it can only grow from there and we'll see.
If you're writing music in Herefordshire and Worcestershire, be part of it. Upload your music to bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
So ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Evesham Arts Centre.
Now, an amazing talent from Marden in Herefordshire. Now, Marden's between Hereford and Leinster. Let's just paint the picture. Nothing really grows there apart from strawberries and one incredible musician, Bo Walton. Now, he started learning music back at the age of 8 or 9 years old. He used to listen to a lot of his dad's albums, inspired by Elvis, Eddie Cochran, also Buddy Holly and Billy Fury. So much so that when he got into a band when he was 16, he decided that he was going to carry on with some of these influences. But his dad didn't leave him at that. He thought, I'm going to send this into a record label. And he's just been picked up by Tabitha Music and some of his works being published by music giants EMI. He's also been working with Mark Knopfler from Dire Straits. So without any further ado, Bo Walton!
There's a girl that I'm just crazy.
crazy about. She's the one that I can't live without. And yet that's just what I'm doing now. But I still believe in love somehow. And that's the reason, that's the reason I'm hanging on. But I'm still hanging on. She used to feel the same for me. I felt sure that it was meant to be. And then it seemed my world fell down. But I still believe we'll turn it round. And that's the reason, that's the reason I'm hanging on. Yeah, that's the reason, that's the reason I'm hanging on. Oh, I'm crying, feel like dying. But I'm still hanging on. Well, I wish that it could be the way it used to be. Oh, it looks like love has gone, but I'm still hanging on, hanging on. To let her know I didn't mean to let her go. And she'll come back to me. I still believe. And that's the reason, that's the reason I'm hanging on. Yeah, that's the reason, that's the reason I'm hanging on. But I'm still hanging on. Come back to me.
Yeah, still hanging on.
I'll be here forever. Yeah, I'm still hanging on.
Thank you very much.
Andrew Marston, you're very tall.
I can work with it.
This is my first single.
It's called Too Much.
I told her straight last night, don't wanna settle down. She couldn't understand why I'm leaving town. She talked a real good fight, but didn't change my mind. Cause I'm really gonna do it, I'm gonna do it this time. Cause I can see it all
from my name in lights.
I'm just a country boy, but I'm a star tonight. Crowd goes wild, they're really lapping it up. Wouldn't that be something? Woo, it's too much. That's why I'm leaving. That's the way it's gotta be. Can't help believing there's something out there for me. Well, I didn't wanna make the blue. It's just something I gotta do. And boy, if it all came true, it's too much. Myself, I'll be a fool to try. I gotta chase that dream. I
can't let it die. I gotta go now. It's tough to leave her. It's rough, but I want this crazy dream. Much too much, too much, too much, too much. No, I didn't want to make her blue. It's just something I gotta do. I'm boy, if it all came true, it's too much. Woo! I gotta take my chance. I gotta roll the dice. And if it don't work out, I'm gonna pay the price. But if I get the breaks from Lady Luck, I'm gonna steal the show, yeah. Woo, it's too much. That's why I'm leaving. That's the way it's gotta be. I can't help believing there's something out there for me. Well, I didn't want to make her blue. It's just something I gotta do. Boy, if it all came true, it's too much. No, I didn't want to make her blue. It's just something I gotta do. And boy, if it all came true, it's too much. Gotta go, honey. Catch me on the late show. It's too much.
So thank you very much. And I want to say thank you to Hereford Worcester for putting this on, and thank you to all the other bands that are here, and thank you for you guys for coming out. It's very, very cool to see you all. Thank you. It's nice that so many people come out and support local live acts, so thank you very much. I'm going to take it down a little bit. It's a song from the album Waiting on Dream, Another Sleepless Night. Without her. Her memory. Don't let me sleep. I spend my nights just walking. Those promises I didn't keep, they haunt me still. Oh, I caught her up. She slams it down. She says it's no use talking. She says I should forget her now, but I know I never will. I'm on a one-way ticket out of here, and though it says I'm freedom bound, I may be losing my mind, 'cause every station sign still tells me I'm down in heartbreak town. In heartbreak town. Been going round and round, it seems. This train is going nowhere. I've seen these signs for broken dreams 100 times before. No, I can't reach the point of no return. It must be out there somewhere. But that's a bridge can't seem to burn, although she don't care no more. Well, I'm on a one-way ticket out of here, and though it says I'm freedom bound, well, I may be losing my mind, 'cause every station sign still tells me I'm down in heartbreak town. Heartbreak town. In heartbreak town.
in Heartbreak Town.
Listen to hundreds of live gigs.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
And I might say, who's company am I blessed with here? Who have I got?
Well, I'm Rob, and this is Trish.
Hi there.
Hi, Rob and Trish.
I'm actually the drummer's father, who's playing with Boat today.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, so well.
Vested interest, but very impressed with the music. I've heard some of Bo's, and I'm absolutely blown away by it.
Yeah, exactly the same. Really excited about the performance as well. Wasn't expecting that.
Really?
Yeah, really
so,
good.
So has you just been kind of listening to him upstairs, like drumming away, going, oh, you know, that din, and now you hear what it's all for?
Greg's been drumming for years anyway, obviously. Bo's been playing for many years, and they're just good professionals, quite honestly, you know, and this sort of music ought to be heard. Thanks. Terrific harmonies in there, excellent, fantastic guitar work, good drumming, excellent drumming.
Yeah, definitely good drumming. Thank you so much for speaking to me, guys.
That's
cheers.
Right. Thank you.
I've popped into the crowd to speak to some people, and I found the lovely Ron.
Well, I thought he's fantastic. Yeah, because he's my son.
So you must be very proud.
I am. He's a breath of fresh air, really. It's great to hear this type of music back.
Definitely. I think they really hit the nail on the head as well for the kind of genre that they want to go for there.
That's right. No, we just hope it does well and get him out for a tour.
Well, thanks so much for speaking to me today.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi, Alex.
Hello.
What did you think of Bo Walton?
I've seen him a few times and this is definitely the best time.
Really?
Yeah.
What did they do this time that was different?
I just thought because of new band members, I haven't seen him with them before.
Oh, was it? Did you have a favourite song that they did
before? Oh, mine's Too Much.
So I'm here with Graham, who is the manager of a record label, I hear.
I am, yeah, the MD of Tabitha Records, and we're here today with Bo.
Great. So how does that work? Like, how does sort of your job work when you see people that you like?
If I like them, providing they're writing their own material, which is what I need as a publisher, then what we would do is either try to help them on their way as a writer or an artist, either get them recorded, get a record release, get them on the radio, which they've done today on their own volition, which is great, and then promote them, really, and try to get the songs heard across the world, as we're doing with Bo.
So wonderful.
If you get the interest, you get the plays, you get some revenue from that, and it gives people, writers, a lot of confidence then to move on.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, they write more songs. In fact, they get songs coming out their ears, literally. Then they, you know.
So who else is on top of the records that we might have heard of?
Oh, I've got some songs by Adrian Smith, who's with Iron Maiden.
Yep.
I've got a writer in Russia, in St. Petersburg, called Fedi, who is absolutely brilliant.
Is that Fedi?
Fedi, yeah. Fedi Lavrov. His daughter is a violinist in the, one of the big orchestras in London.
Superb.
Lots of artists, a lot of writers. I've got a guy called MXT up in Birmingham, actually, only just up the road. White reggae singer.
So your reach is quite international then?
Oh, yeah. People all over the world.
Great, wonderful. Okay, thanks so much for talking to me, Graham. Okay.
My name's Meg, and my name is consultant, and I quite often come in and talk to Tony Fisher in the morning.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I'm kind of here today to help support Bo Walton, because I used to go to school with him, and I just haven't seen him since we left school, however many years ago.
No, really?
I'm not saying the number. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to hearing him. I've heard his single, so I'm really looking forward to seeing him live and hearing what's coming up next.
Text 81333
and start your message with HW.
BBC introducing.
Be part of it.
In Hereford and Worcester.